NCAA football highlight film. These kids had a great season, 7 victories and only 4 losses. Third winning season in a row. Most importantly, the reason we were successful is they came in the weight room at 6:30 in the morning. They were here in July workouts. They started through the heat of 2-a-days in August. But most importantly, they came together as a team when they had to. They became that family that's very, very important. And because of that, we made it to the sectional championship. Ladies and gentlemen, when this team took the field, they played like champions.
As for enthusiasm, you know, I think that everybody has their own way of expressing it. Not everybody has to hoop and holler, but you can just tell when somebody is ready to go and they're psyched up to begin. And when you think about emotion, I mean, you can't play a sport without emotion. And in football especially, each game is just incredibly emotional.
We went 7-4, not 4-4. Was that because last year, after the season was over, we weren't satisfied with ourselves, the seniors on the team, this year's seniors, and that everyone thought that last year was the best that we could get. But we realized if we work hard in the weight room and worked hard during practice, that it was only the beginning.
I had a blast with this year's team. It was a good year. Last year, it was fun. This year, it was family. That's what it's about. down and really wondered what the season was going to be like. But it seemed like all the seniors knew what we had to do. They knew that we had to put close together, become a family, and give out a little extra effort.
I saw that when we turned in fourth our season. I saw everybody on the team. I saw everybody on the team become closer, work harder. Nobody gave up. We just kept on working. We knew we had Homestead next week. We knew they were rated. We didn't know what to expect. When we came out and played football, we beat Homestead. And that really gave us momentum to the rest of the season.
So hard of mine, felt hurt. poster idea actually came about at a girls' basketball game last year when Mr. Fricky approached us with the idea of showing us a Bears poster. And me and Tony Trent at the time really caught on to it and really thought it would be a good idea. And as regards to the We Will Rock You across the top, I think that came about because ever since I came here as a freshman, I know Mr. Fricky expressed that what Columbia City needed to be known for to get respect in our conference and in Northeastern Indiana was that we're going to hit people. And this was a good phrase that would show that we expressed to other teams and people around the community that we were going to
seniors, Troy Wilcoxon, number 80. Bart Cook, number 84. Tony Trier, number 54. Tim Harold, number 41. Greg Starkey, number 32. Chris Brigham, number 40. Hank Nolan, number 74. Todd Keister, number 35. Chad Hollenball, number 50. Blake Fall, number 19. Chad Igney, number 83. Jay Coy, number 81. Aaron Cook, number 20. Andy Wellborn, number 82. Troy Gothrop, number 60. Jeff Geiger, number 77. Kurt Bigue, number 70. Joe Locks, number 31. Benji Torres, number 27. And Rob Getz, number 61.